Okay, first, we have seen it a couple of times already, actually. So give you a block G. So for example, this block G. So here, I have a vertex covered, B prime, that's a vertex covered. That cover all the edges, right? So then we have this V prime here, and that's the part is V minus V prime. So a vertex cover actually defines a partition of Earth into two parts, V prime and V minus V prime. So then each vertex, either inside here or inside here. So then I can make them corresponding to one here and zero here. In solution, not in solution, right? Okay. So Boolean variable U, either value zero or one. Since you sense this the correspondence, for example, in single edge. If this one corresponding to Boolean variable say U one. Okay. Now this edge is U one. This end is U one bar. Two little lobes. So if I take this vertex, that means U1 get value 1. If I have this situation, that's corresponding to U1 equals 0. So do you sense the corresponding between choose assignment and vertex cover? So for each edge, if each edge I allow to use one vertex, each edge I allow to use one vertex, so I have this situation. So what happens is, for each vertex, I will give it one edge. My quota for vertex cover is exactly four vertices. Each edge I need one vertex to cover it. Right, four edges, I need four vertices. So that will ensure I use exactly one vertex for each edge. So each edge corresponding to a little, to a pooling variable here. So it's U1, I marked it U1, U2, sorry, U1 bar, and here U2, U2 bar, U3. So this part will correspond to choose setting. So this one corresponding to choose setting. So we call the choose setting component to indicate the corresponding to choose setting. So for vertex cover, this one I use exactly one edge and one vertex for each edge. So quota will be 4. All right. Now for clause, how can I represent that the clause is satisfied? Clause contains three literals. So naturally, I will use a graph with three vertices to represent a clause, because three. But here, look, each variable is a vertex. So naturally, for this clause, I will use three vertices to represent it, right? Because there are three literals. So this. U1, U2 bar, U4. So that and U3, yeah, it's the first one U3, sorry. So use three vertices to represent these three literals in the class. And now I use a triangle to represent them. How many vertices do I need to cover all the edges in a triangle? Two. Because one vertex covers two edges, is another one. So exactly two edges. All right. So if I give each class quota of two for each vertex cover, so all edges will be covered. Okay, so what we do is, Are you free? So they have different names, actually they represent different vertex, they're related, okay. So maybe I use, I just leave it exactly for time being, okay. So that's cross part. So you see, each will need two vertices to cover all edges. Quota is two vertices. So that part, we'll use them to test whether each cross is satisfied or not. So here is that section. These satisfaction testing components. Okay. Now, you see that same represent the same variable, same versus, there must be some relation, right? So to indicate there's have some relation, what we do is add some edges. These use as communication between this part and this part. So we have some communication. So what we do is, if labor is same, I just add an edge. The same one, add an edge here. That's the construction of block. That's block G. Time is obviously linear time, very quickly. Then K will be set into here, size of U, each edge get one. Here twice, for size of C. That's the value of K. Okay. Now let me explain how was the effect of these edges. Okay. Now look at this one. So the effect of this one is this. If you look at this picture, forget about this one. Okay. Now for this one, I give it exactly two vertices. So two vertices, regardless how I choose, for example, this one and this one, it will cover all edge inside. Also two edges going outside, but one will not be covered. For each clause, exactly one will not be covered. So that's the important part. This edge is not covered. When we have a vertex cover, this edge must cover from this end, right? So that means the value of this vertex will be one. In order to cover this edge, the value of this one will be one. That will cover all edges. Okay, so this. So now, suppose we have a choose assignment for this one. So what happens? For example, this one I can set. For example, this one. So my K vertex cover will correspond to this one. If one, I just choose this one. Zero, I choose this one. 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 So all these edges will be covered. Alright. So now this one is satisfied. Satisfied means what? One literal you get value one. So here, this one is get value 1. Because you want it 1, right? So this one gets value 1. So it covers each versus. So that will take care of all these edges together with these. Now this edge is taken care of by this end. So similarly, this one has a 2 literal. Maybe here is U3. So I cover these two. And this one you covered by this end. So I have a two assignments that give me a k versus column. So one direction. Okay. So the other direction is very important with that this poker. K versus. So here exactly n versus. Here exactly 2c versus. So that means two versus for each triangle, one vertex for each edge here. So that means I use exactly one vertex for each edge here, exactly two edges, two vertices for each triangle here. So that means no conflict. Exactly one is in vertex and one is not. So I can use that to define the choose assignment. If it's in vertex cover, I give value one, otherwise not. Okay. So here I have a vertex cover. For example, this one is a vertex cover. So I use this to define choose assignment. Maybe I use a different, use same one is okay. So these verses, including some vertex cover, their value will be one. Now consider a clause. It contains exact two verses in the vertex cover. Okay, but two can only cover five edges, not six. One edge must be covered by outside. So this edge is covered by outside. Outside means this value gets value one. So therefore, this clause is satisfied. Okay. All right. So my suggestion is use a different example, work out the reduction by yourself, then convince yourself that both direction works. Okay. So unfortunately, tomorrow is holiday for you. Okay. Enjoy your holiday and.